Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Enjoy Biochemistry. I am Dr. Trupti and in this video we are going to learn about a very important case study, that is alkaptonuria. Let's begin with a case study. A 63-year-old man presented with sudden onset of severe hip pain for the past 1 month. Physical examination revealed black pigmentation of sclera and blackening of earlobes. The urine darkened on standing in air. X-ray showed degenerative changes in the right hip joint, and biochemical investigations, which included urine Benedict test and ammoniacal silver nitrate test, were positive. The various questions that can be asked are: mention the probable diagnosis and give justification for the same. Mention the cause of a disorder. Explain the cause of darkening of urine on standing. Explain the biochemical basis of common sign and symptoms of the disorder, for example, black pigmentation of sclera and blackening of earlobes, degenerative changes in the hip joint, etc. How the condition is diagnosed and how the condition is managed. So in this video, we are going to find out answers of all these questions. In the given case study, patient is suffering from the disorder of amino acid metabolism, that is alkaptonuria. This is the first inborn error of metabolism to be identified. British physician Garrod, he introduced the phrase, that is inborn error of metabolism, in 1908, and he was the first one to describe all the features of alkaptonuria in 1902. This alkaptonuria is an autosomal recessive condition, the incidence of which is 1 in 250,000 births. Alkaptonuria is one of the condition of Garrod's tetrad, and this tetrad is formed by the four important metabolic diseases which are inherited, like albinism, alkaptonuria, pentosuria and cystinuria. This condition alkaptonuria has very interesting historical aspect as well. Stein et al. In 1977 provided evidence that the Egyptian mummy Harva, dating from 1500 BC, had alkaptonuria. What is the cause of alkaptonuria? In the phenylalanine and tyrosine metabolism, this enzyme homogentisic acid oxidase, it converts homogentisic acid to malyl acetoacetate. So if there is homogentisic acid oxidase deficiency, this homogentisic acid cannot be converted to malyl acetoacetate, and its levels are built up in the blood as well as it is excreted in the urine. So due to increased concentration of homogentisic acid, various characteristic features occur in alkaptonuria. So the major characteristic features of this condition are darkening of urine on standing, means when it is exposed to air, arthritis, especially spine is involved, and black pigmentation of cartilages, and this condition is called as ochronosis. So these three are important characteristic features of alkaptonuria. In addition to this, there can be calcification of coronary artery and aortic wall secondary to this ochronosis. And urolithiasis in the middle or late adulthood is also common. So alkaptonuria is characterized by defect in the homogentisic acid oxidase, which leads to increased level of homogentisic acid, which is then excreted in the urine, and it leads to darkening of urine on standing, arthritis and ochronosis. What is the biochemical basis of various characteristic features seen in alkaptonuria? The first characteristic feature is blackening of urine on standing. So in this alkaptonuria, there is excretion of homogentisic acid in urine, and this homogentisic acid on standing, means when urine is kept on standing, when it is exposed to air or sunlight, it oxidizes to the corresponding quinone, that is benzoquinone acetate, that polymerizes to give a dark color. And this dark coloring of discoloration of urine, it is increased when this urine is exposed to sunlight or air. And when the urine is kept in a test tube, this darkening starts from the top layer. And due to the development of this black color, this condition is also called as black urine disease. And black staining of diaper is one of the earliest signs that is seen in infants or neonates who are suffering from this condition, alkaptonuria. There is development of ochronosis seen in alkaptonuria. What is the cause? There is oxidation of homogenticic acid or homogenticate by polyphenol oxidase to form benzoquinone acetate. And this benzoquinone acetate is polymerized to black colored pigment called as alkapton bodies. And these alkapton bodies are later deposited in various tissues, organs, like cartilages, bones. So most affected are cartilage of pin of ear, nose cartilage, then sclera of eyes, intervertebral disc, and joint cavities. So the deposition of alkapton bodies in various organs, connective tissue is called as ochronosis. And this develops in the third or fourth decade of life. Due to deposition of this alkapton bodies in the intervertebral disc or in the joint cavity, it leads to the condition arthritis. And these are the blackening of urine on standing, ochronosis, arthritis. These are the characteristic features seen in alkaptonuria. Now, how this alkaptonuria is diagnosed? So, for the diagnosis of alkaptonuria, various tests can be done. First is the ferric chloride test. In this test, to the urine sample, ferric chloride solution is added and urine turns blue-green color, and this test is positive in alkaptonuria. Second, Benedict test is also positive and it gives greenish-brown precipitate. Ammoniacal silver nitrate test is also positive and it gives black color. Quantitative estimation of homogenticic acid in urine can be done by HPLC, that is high pressure liquid chromatography, and identification of homogenticic acid can also be done by gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, or mass spectrometry, tandem mass spectrometry. How this alkaptonuria is managed? It is not a dangerous condition and it does not require any specific treatment. Restriction of phenylalanine and tyrosine in the diet should be done, and the intake should be less than 500 mg per day. Administration of vitamin C, that is 1 gram per day, is very important because it prevents oxidation of homogenticic acid to benzoquinone acetate, and it further leads to reduced polymerization and pigment deposition on the connective tissue because of the antioxidant property of vitamin C, and that's why it is given in this in the patients of alkaptonuria. Then the one drug which is FDA approved drug for treatment of tyrosinemia type 1 can also be given to treat the patients of alkaptonuria, that is nitazinone. It is parahydroxyphenylpyruvate dioxygenase inhibitor. So what it does, this enzyme parahydroxyphenylpyruvate dioxygenase is responsible for conversion of parahydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogenticic acid. So this nitazinone, it will block or inhibit this enzyme, so the conversion of parahydroxyphenylpyruvate to homogenticic acid will be inhibited. So there will be decreased homogenticic acid and there will be more excretion of parahydroxyphenylpyruvate through urine. So the side effects or the deleterious effect of homogenticic acid on the body can be minimized by giving this drug nitazinone. So these are all the management modalities or treatment options which are available for the treatment of alkaptonuria. Let's summarize the topic by discussing the answers of this case study. So the first question was, mention the probable diagnosis and give justification. So in this case study, the probable diagnosis is alkaptonuria, and it is alkaptonuria because the patient on physical examination revealed that there is black pigmentation of sclera and blackening of ear lobes, which is common in alkaptonuria, and the urine darkened on standing in air, so that is the characteristic features, and X-ray showed degenerative changes in the right hip joint, means it denotes arthritis. So the arthritis, ochronosis, and darkening of urine, these are the characteristic features. In addition to that, Benedict test and silver nitrate test were also positive. So because of this, we can say that this is the case of alkaptonuria. What is the cause of this disorder? The cause is defect in homogenticic acid oxidase enzyme deficiency. What is the cause of darkening of urine on standing? So on standing, urine becomes alkaline and the homogentisic acid which is excreted in urine, it is auto-oxidizes to its benzoquinone acetate form which polymerizes to dark color, and that's why urine becomes dark on standing when it is exposed to air or sunlight. The biochemical basis of common sign and symptoms means why there is black pigmentation of sclera, blackening of ear lobes and degenerative changes in the right hip joints. It is because of the polymerization of benzoquinone acetate, which is formed due to this oxidation of homogentisic acid, and the polymerization leads to formation of alkapton bodies. These alkapton bodies are deposited in various connective tissues, bones, joints, and it leads to black pigmentation of sclera, blackening of ear lobes, and arthritis. How the condition is diagnosed? There are various tests which can be done to diagnose, like ferric chloride test, Benedict test, ammoniacal silver nitrate test, and quantitative estimation by tandem mass spectrometry (HPLC) can be done. How the condition is managed? As such, this condition, most of the patient remain asymptomatic in the third or fourth decade. Patient presents with the arthritis. So low phenylalanine diet is the mainstay. Then vitamin C can be given to the patient, and one drug is there, nitazinone, which is FDA approved drug for the treatment of tyrosinemia type 1, can also be given if required in this condition. This is the second case of alkaptonuria, which you can have in the exam. A mother came to the hospital with her 2 months old child with the complaint that diapers used for the child were stained with dark urine. On exposure to the air, the stains became more blackish. Benedict test was positive, but glucose oxidase test was negative. So here also the diagnosis is alkaptonuria, and this diapers stained with dark urine, and on exposure the stains became more blackish. It is the commonest and earliest presentation or sign that is seen in the patient of alkaptonuria. If you find this video useful, please subscribe, like and share, and thank you for watching.